I'm going to go ahead and continue on my second topic. And it's going to be identified as the next echo, Nsakis, Dolahata, Oho, Edity, Bitsisile, Bindi, Big Echo, Otas, Big Aho, Inaiti, Uliao. Akut apa nak disini? Abel kan kerja. I believe the translation into English would be something like, I want to talk about the power and energy of Navajo philosophy of knowledge and teaching. That would be my title. Again, today I want to take this opportunity to extend my appreciation, gratitude, admiration, and respect to all of you out there. Again, that might take this opportunity to listen to Navajo philosophy of knowledge. Again, my name is Wilson Aronio Jr. Like I said, I'm originally from a place called Cliff Rose Creek, New Mexico. And a lot of this second portion of Navajo philosophy of teaching came from my grandmother. She's the one that taught me this, so that's what I'm going to share with all of you once more again at this time. And relating to this topic, my topic is going to be the power and energy of Navajo philosophy of knowledge and teaching. My grandmother said, Navajo philosophy of knowledge has a lot of power in itself, and if you use it right, it can give you a good guidance in life. You have to use its natural method of power in a positive, good way. You have to understand that first. One of the power of our Navajo philosophy is to be honest with yourself and to be truthful with yourself and commit yourself to what life is all about, education is all about, in an honest way. That's what my grandmother said. That's what you have to learn first. So I guess to say that Navajo philosophy's power is honesty and being truthful, which relates to the concept of our Navajo identification, which is our Navajo clan system. Our clan system that relates to the mythic and the knowledge of Keh. The closest translation that we came up with to define the meaning of Keh is kinship. So that's the word I'm going to use. So Keh, kinship, means your home environment, your social environment of your life, your spiritual holistic environment, your common environment, and that relates to your physical growth in development in your life. That's what you have to understand to determine where you're coming from, who you are, what you are, and the purpose in your life. And as a Navajo, we always have four clan, which is the study of our life. Our first clan, we represent a mother's clan, which is the significant meaning of our red blood flow. This becomes the concept of our feeling, thought, and thinking, and our strength to be positive and to establish a good positive attitude towards everything we are going to do. That's our first clan, the power of our philosophy. Our second clan, we are born for our father's clan, which is identified as our white blood cell. This becomes the philosophy of our endeavors of life, our strategies, our plan, our vision, mission. What we're going to learn and how we're going to survive in the world we are living, which is identified as our self-reliance, self-esteem, motivation, and being very enthusiastic to do something good in our life. And this is how we develop a good positive behavior, to behave ourselves, to follow our natural law. Our third clan is our maternal grandfather's clan, which identifies our blue blood cell. This will make us understand why we look so beautiful, why we have to understand our attitude, our behavior, and our personality to develop a positive character in our life. Our fourth clan is our paternal grandfather's clan, which is identified as our glittering black blood cell, which becomes our self-awareness, how we protect ourselves from harm, evil, and danger. It's the interpretation of our true self, our honesty, and self-responsibility. These are the teachings that come from our clan. So in that sense, kinship is the understanding of how we express our kinship by our clan and bloodline to show good feeling, thought, and thinking, love for one another. Expression kinship is a very effective communication within our family setting, relative, and people. So there is a good understanding and comprehensions and respect within our society. Kinship is our ethics and principle that makes us never to intermarry into our own full basic clan, because if we do, it's going to affect our mental capability, our social capability, our emotional capability, our spiritual capability, and our physical capability negatively. That's how we hurt ourselves, endanger our life, and we will never have good health in our life. So this ethics and principle was made to keep our blood flow pure and clean and productive. And it goes on from generation to generation. And then they say that kinship is our family unity with the right attitude, behavior, personality, and character, and the way that we express our native Navajo language to one another, expressing kinship, love towards one another, was the highest important in our philosophy. It has a lot of power. That's what my grandma said. Also, kinship ethics applies emotional health and well-being. So if you apply all this power of philosophy of knowledge, you're going to have a long life, a solid concept of love, a firm, solid foundation, and that's where you can have self-confidence and competency to live in peace and harmony. That's the way, that's one of the power that our clanship has. Now, based upon what I just covered, I'm going to come up with 10 steps to explain the power of Navajo philosophy of knowledge and teaching. We'll go by questioning. As a Navajo, or as an individual, how can I use some of the power of Navajo philosophy, knowledge, and teaching? The answer is, we have to learn to understand that there is a beautiful, positive level of understanding. And then sometimes there is a negative part of understanding, too, where we have to be real careful. Based upon that, I'm going to go to 10 concepts. Number one, many of our Navajo philosophy teaching can change the courses of our journey in life, meaning that sometimes we take things for granted and abuse it to take control. Sometimes we always try to control something that we cannot control. And so, or sometimes we don't understand a part of our life that we can control that will benefit us. So we have to go back to the power and knowledge of our Navajo philosophy. And then over and over again, we are given hints and guidance in many forms and in many ways through the power of our Navajo knowledge. But for some of us, to do any good, we must be able to notice and interpret what we are getting ourselves into and what are we going to get out of what we want. That's important. We must learn the positive side of our understanding so we can use the power of our Navajo philosophy to control our life. We will have to be really careful with it. They say that discipline has to be there. Number two, Navajo philosophy of teaching does have a lot of power. They are beautiful and good if you use it in the right way. But then sometimes it seems like it is like all powers, because its focus can be positive or it can be negative, but it's going to determine how you use it. It's up to you. Now, my grandma said, positive Navajo philosophy teaching can make you understand the energy in the universe, in the divine creation, so that you can understand your spirit, your soul, so that you will understand your purpose in life. And one of the things you will understand is you have to learn to keep your spirit clean, your soul clean, your blood flow clean, your mind clean, and your body clean. And this is how you will learn to protect yourself from negative energy and power. That's what my grandma said. Now, sometimes that negative understanding is not good for all of us. Unfortunately, not all energy and power in this world, universe, are good. Not all spirit or power have a wealth, they have a welfare at heart or cares for you. So you need to protect yourself from the power, energy, and personalities who do not wish you well. Sometimes the concept of various philosophies doesn't really wish you well. They try to manipulate you in a negative way. So they said, be careful about your life. To see a holy divine light in your life, that's where love and happiness of life and wisdom comes from. Meaning, there is a real beautiful positive power of learning in our life. Number three, like today, some individual use it for good and some use it for evil. This kind of thinking understanding comes from mankind viewpoint. This is where a lot of confusion, misunderstanding comes from. This is where we begin not to believe in our Navajo philosophy. So we end up not believing in ourselves. That's how people say, I don't believe in myself, I don't trust myself. That's what they say. And from this, it becomes our doubtful feeling. Even the smallest doubtful feeling can block your ability and your talent, your purpose in life completely. So be careful. Number four, now it seems like it's really up to you and me, all of you, to use the power of your philosophy in a good way, not an evil way. Like that's what we were told. Use your novel philosophy with intelligence, with power and energy in the right way. We are told that when we follow the natural order of the holy people's discipline, then we use the power of Navajo philosophy in the correct, honest way. But on the other hand, if we follow too much man-made philosophy, sometimes we end up abusing our own philosophy and other philosophy. Then we get sort of get out of control. So they say, don't do that. Number five, if we were on a negative part of our life, our Navajo knowledge is the power that can change the courses of our journey in life. Our Navajo philosophy, my grandmother said, it's like your mother and your father. It's like the spirit and power of your grandmother and your grandfather. So you have to turn back to your own philosophy to get back on the right path of your life. Number six, Navajo philosophy power can make us come to our senses to understand our Navajo thoughts. The power of our Navajo philosophy teaching helps us understand our intuitive side of our feeling that relates to our intuition, feeling and thought. It can help us. Number seven, we will realize that our intuitive self communicates through our life sense and our emotion. Our intuitive may often have a favorite or certain concept of senses, which is we call today common sense. There is a spiritual philosophy of common sense that our people used to believe in. Is how we say it. And this will help you get in touch with your positive conscious mind. In this sense, it will balance your subconscious mind. And this is how you can learn to use all your five senses to get into your innermost mind, then into your innermost wisdom, your innermost self as an individual. Number eight, through our philosophy of knowledge means your Navajo thought is the spirit of your journey and your life. Positive thought had a lot to do with our life, like Grandma said. But again, negative thought have a lot to do with our life today as well. Did you know that? So we have to be really careful being a Navajo, being an individual. Number nine, being happy is beautiful. It's a good medicine. It's a healer. The holy people gave us that happiness to understand. So as a Navajo, the way you feel about yourself, about what you have to do, will greatly, tremendously affect the way you do it. If you are happy, you will be done sooner. You will have fewer problems, enjoy happiness of yourself and other people. You will never question yourself. If you are angry or dissatisfied, your work, what you want to do, will drag on. You'll never be successful. You'll make mistakes, and the people around you will go out of their way to avoid you. And that's how you can say, that person doesn't look at me. I don't know what I did. It's your attitude and behavior and your language. They said, so be careful. Remember that you have a grandmother and grandfather and your mother and father, like me. They said this, you're about as happy as you can make up your mind to be. You might have to work at it, but you start by thinking wonderful, happy thoughts. Put all your fears, angry, unwillingness, and your frustration and your disappointment out of your mind. You don't have time for that. Be happy towards what you're going to do, other people. Look for happy things in your life that is enjoyable. Don't look for negative things. The last one, number 10, my grandmother said, try to develop a happy, healthy attitude, behavior, and personality to go ahead and learn a good philosophy of knowledge that will help you live good. Go to work on all the things you have been putting up. Don't be lazy, because if you're lazy, it's no good. Lazy people develop a bad, negative attitude and behavior. You will never achieve anything. So when you're not lazy, you will always remember to listen, to learn, to know yourself and understand yourself. Think about your mental capability, your emotional capability, And the limitation and level of achievement that are open to you, there's a good, beautiful opportunity waiting for you out there. Examine, re-look, re-clarify, re-analyze your vision, mission, and goals and objectives to see if they are really positively attainable. Learn to recognize and understand your moods, your attitude, your behavior. Your moods becomes your conscious state of your Navajo mind in which your emotional gains control of your attitude, behavior, personality. Remember, they work for you. Make it work for you. Don't make it work against you. This way, you're going to have a beautiful life. That's what Grandma told me. So these are some of the feelings that and thoughts and things that I still have shared with you, and I hope that you could understand what I'm trying to say, what I'm talking about. This is Navajo philosophy of traditional knowledge that our people and young people lived by long time ago. Today we're a little bit different. We're educated in a different perspective. Maybe that's the reason why. Thank you.